So we're going to talk about overwintering your bonsai today. There are two things you need to decide. The first is this a tree that is an indoor tree or an outdoor tree? The other thing you have to decide is where are you going to put that tree if it is indoor or outdoor? So let's talk about the first point. Is it an indoor tree or an outdoor tree? Well, usually this is pretty easy to figure out, but if you're not sure about what species you have and where it, what kind of needs it has, you can easily look this up online. If it's a tropical tree, it's going to need to be indoors, presuming that you live in a place up north where it gets cold in the winter, like I do in Pennsylvania. If it's a deciduous tree, so a tree where the leaves normally fall off in the wintertime, like a maple, for example, then it's going to be an outdoor tree. If it's a pine or an evergreen of some sort, it's probably an outdoor tree. But there are some evergreens that normally grow in temperate zones that will need to be kept inside. So first you have to figure out where that tree normally lives and grows. If it normally lives and grows somewhere up north where it gets cold in the winter, then you probably want to plan on finding a way to keep that tree outdoor through the winter. Why is that? Well, because outdoor trees need a period of what's called dormancy. And dormancy is critical for the health of the tree. Dormancy is a period where the tree sort of goes to sleep. It basically hibernates. And it needs that period of time to stay healthy. If you take an outdoor tree, let's take as an example a Japanese maple, and you don't let it go dormant, so you keep it in a warm place year round, what will happen is, not at first, but as the years go by, the tree will get exhausted. It will get weaker year after year. It needs to have that dormancy period to regain its vigor. Think of it sort of like sleeping for human beings. If you stay up night after night after night, you can get away with that for a while, but it's going to take a toll on your body. And trees are the same way. Trees that grow up in tropical regions won't need that dormancy period. They're not used to it. They don't need it. They've adapted. So they can stay inside all winter long. Now, even outdoor trees need to be protected during the winter because they are in a small pot. You have to remember that. The tree, even if it's a pine tree that normally can withstand very cold temperatures, if planted in the ground, because it's in a pot, the roots are more exposed. They aren't insulated by the ground around it, and they're very shallow. So the roots are very easily damaged by cold winter temperatures. So you're going to have to figure out a plan for what you're going to do, regardless of whether it's an outdoor tree or an indoor tree. So this is option one. If you have an outdoor tree and you don't have a lot of places to keep it protected over the winter, this is one of the best ways to do it, is you just bury it in the ground. A few episodes ago, we took this Shimpaku juniper and we planted it in the ground. This is actually in a pot. It's in a training pot, but I've buried it in here because I want to train it to get big and thick and encourage the roots to grow beyond the confines of the pot and into the soil around the pot to encourage the tree to grow more vigorously and thicker. So now that it's in the ground here, it should be nice and safe over the winter because it's insulated by the dirt around it. So that's option one. So the problem with option one is that it's kind of a pain in the butt to take all of your bonsai, assuming that you have a bunch of them, and dig a hole and bury them in the ground and cover it up again every year. That's kind of time consuming, and there may be faster, easier ways to do this. So this is the option that I rely on for my outdoor bonsai. Fortunately, I'm lucky enough to have a basement. Now, you may not have a basement, so we'll talk about other options if you don't have a basement. But if you have a basement, this may be an option for you if you have steps going down into your basement from the outside like I have here. So these steps are a nice place to store your bonsai if you've got them. What I'm gonna do over this winter is I will take all of my outdoor trees, like this juniper here, and I will just set them down in the stairwell. Now, the temperature in the stairwell matters a lot. If you have a stairwell that's really warm, and I mean by above, you know, 50 degrees or so through the winter months, then that may actually be too warm. Your steps probably won't get that warm, but it might be smart to take a thermometer and measure the temperature in your stairwell during the winter months. The tree will wake up if it gets too warm out. And if you keep it in the steps like this, like where there's no light, then the tree will get sick and die in addition to waking up because it won't have any sunlight. So you've got to watch out for that. If it gets too cold in your stairwell, so if it gets down, say, into the low to mid-20s, I mean, there's a gray zone where your tree may or may not be okay. But if it gets much below 30 in the coldest days of the year, then it may be too cold for your tree. So the bottom line is, check and make sure that you know what the temperature is in your stairwell over the winter, particularly over the coldest days. But if it's insulated enough by the house and by the dirt around your house, then stairwells like this can just be a perfect place to store your bonsai. And don't worry about the fact that it's dark with the doors closed over winter. Even an evergreen really doesn't need light in order to get through the dormant winter months. But once it starts waking up, it will need light. Another option for protecting your outdoor trees over the winter would be to keep them up close to the house and insulated by the warmth that comes from your house. Now, I don't have window wells around my basement windows here. So this is a basement window, but you can see that it's above ground. If you live in a house where you have a basement and the window well is slightly below ground, the window is, then you may have an aluminum window well around the window that goes, you know, a foot or two below the ground level. And that well there may be a really excellent place to put your tree because you don't have to dig a hole and bury it, but it will also be insulated. Now, you may need to supplement it by filling it with some sort of material to help insulate it some more. Snow is a great insulator, but if it gets really cold, you know, in the teens or below, and that window well may not be adequately insulated on its own, although, again, you can check with a thermometer, but you may need to supplement with dirt or hay or something else to try to help and keep that those plants a little insulated. Another place to overwinter your trees would be the garage. Now, garages may work and may not work for you. This garage here that I have does not work for me. It is not attached to the house and it isn't heated and it doesn't even have windows. So it gets very cold in there. It's just as cold in there as it is pretty much in the outside air over the winter. So it doesn't provide a whole lot of insulation benefit. If your garage is connected to your house, then it may be warm enough because it's up against your warm house. It may be warm enough in there to keep it above freezing, but also below the 50s or so, and keep your plants at a perfect range where you really don't have to do much except just sort of put them there. Other options, if you don't have a garage and you don't have a basement, if you live in an apartment where there is an entranceway before you get to your door, of your apartment, so maybe a hallway that isn't insulated really or heated, that might be an adequate place. Depends on how cold it gets. If it's heated, then it's not going to be cold enough. Even if it's unheated, it may be too warm in there to keep your plants dormant through the winter, but that may work. Another option would be a cold frame. A cold frame, I don't have an example here to show you because I don't use them, but it's a really simple idea. It's basically just a box, usually made out of wood or plastic, and with a clear paneling on the top and the sides made out of glass or plastic. And that box is sort of like a tiny greenhouse that you can set over your trees, and you might dig a small hole for the trees, set them in the hole, put the frame over top of the trees so that they get a little bit of insulation from the ground. And then the idea of the cold frame box is that it allows sun to come through and warm that space and keep it from getting too cold in there. The problem with cold frames is that you can't really control the temperature very well. And that's why I don't use them. In the winter time in Pennsylvania, it's very dark and gray most of the winter. We don't get a lot of sunlight that would be helpful to insulate that cold frame box. So a cold frame box here isn't going to give me a whole lot of insulation value. Even if it's sunny, the problem is that it may get too warm in the cold frame. It may jump up to above, 60, 70 degrees in that box, depending on how much direct sunlight it's getting, say in the middle of the afternoon. And that may cause your plants to wake up from dormancy, or may even cause them to become damaged in some way from excessive heat. The other option to a cold frame is a full-size greenhouse, which does the same job, but you have a lot more control potentially over the temperature. The problem with a greenhouse is that then you've got to provide ways to heat it and ventilate it, and they're big and expensive to build, and so that's why I don't have a full-size greenhouse. So I've discussed some of the options that you've got for overwintering your outdoor trees. Let's talk about a couple for overwintering your indoor trees.